once the aortic or mitral valve disease is diagnosed, it is a progressive disease. The progression may be very slow also sometimes. Sometimes the stenosis or the shortening or the shrinkage of valve can be only 1 to 2 millimeter per year. So, a regular follow-up of this patient with echocardiogram is the most important method of assessing this patient and find out their prognosis or mean their progress. When the mitral stenosis or the mitral valve becomes somewhat 1.5 centimeter diameter or surface area becomes 1.5 centimeter square centimeter, which the normal value is about 4 square centimeter, then the patient start developing mild symptoms. When they reach the stenosis or the shortening of the valve reaches 1 millimeter, then they have got severe symptoms and they may even go for severe pulmonary edema, nocturnal pulmonary edema or paroxysmal nocturnal pulmonary edema. In the case of mitral regurgitation, the duration of the onset and the duration of the symptoms development may be even longer, and sometimes the patient with the severe mitral regurgitation or blood leaking through the mitral valve, they can go on like that without much problem for much more longer time. So in aortic valve, the symptom starts slightly early, and once the aortic pressure gradient between the left ventricle and aorta is more than 60 millimeter of mercury, we strongly suggest them to undergo operation and replace these valves with the artificial valve or sometimes repair the valve also. The main investigation or the main test we need to do in valve cases are number 1 ECG, number 2 X-ray of the chest, number 3 echocardiogram, and in some cases we need to do coronary angiogram to rule out any existing other disease in the coronary arteries. ECG may give some idea about the heart valve disease, especially if there is valve change or the diameter of the heart chambers are increased. In X-ray also, we will see some findings which will suggest the dilatation or enlargement of heart valves and heart chambers. In mitral stenosis, we may get some evidence from the X-ray about the raised blood pressure in the pulmonary artery or pulmonary circulation. Once the echocardiogram is done, that will give us the correct diagnosis, the stage of the disease, and also give us some information regarding the mode of treatment, at what time you should start the treatment, and what type of treatment can be given, either repair or replacement of the valves. The question always is there any role for medical treatment in the case of heart valve disease? Yes, there is a role for medical treatment. Medicines are effective in early stages of the disease to reduce the symptoms. As such, these drugs, they don't have any control or effect over the progression of the disease. Once a heart valve is diagnosed to be having a disease, that disease is progressive only. It keeps on increasing day by day, but in a very small fraction of millimeter. Usually, mitral stenosis becomes smaller over a period of time, something like once in a year, 1 millimeter or 2 millimeter. From echocardiogram, we can make out the chamber dilatation, the size of the valves, how much calcification is there, and how much thickening in the valve is there, and many other findings. Once the diseases of the heart valves are diagnosed, then it is a continuous process or it is a progressive disease. The first thing is that the patient should be always under medical supervision. If the disease in the early stage, they should undergo evaluation once in a year or maybe once in 2 years, depending on the severity of the disease. As the disease becomes more and more severe, the interval of the evaluation will become shorter. We may have to do test in 1 year, sometimes in 6 months, once in 6 months, and sometimes even once in 3 months to assess the progression of the disease and to find out at exactly at what level we need to interfere with the surgery or non-surgical method to relieve the obstruction in the valve or replace the valve if it is not repairable or dilatable. So, the first thing one has to follow, any patient having a heart valve problem, the first criteria or the first thing they have to do is they should be hooked up to a heart specialist, either a surgeon or a cardiologist, to regularly assess the progression of their disease and take a decision at exactly what time they have to undergo the procedure. The timing of the procedure is very important in heart valve diseases. Early treatment, either by replacement valve or ballooning, also is not good. At the same time, delaying the disease, treatment for longer time beyond certain stage is also dangerous for the patient. So, the best result with the treatment, either surgery or non-surgical method, what is otherwise known as an interventional procedure, the best result we get when we do the procedure at the right time, before the chamber of the heart dilates beyond certain level, or the pumping power or the pumping capacity of the heart becomes lesser beyond certain level. For example, in the case of mitral valve stenosis, 1 centimeter diameter or stage 2B or 3 onwards symptoms, they are advised to undergo very early aortic mitral valve correction, either opening or through the balloon dilatation. In case of aortic stenosis, again a pressure gradient between the left ventricle and aorta is about 60 millimeter of mercury and more, then the operation is suggested to replace this valve. The problem sometimes comes is in the case of regurgitation diseases like mitral valve regurgitation and aortic valve regurgitation, because in regurgitation diseases the patient can go on with the symptom for a long time and they will come at the end of the disease. By the time the good amount of time would have been elapsed and the patient may not get very good result even after operation, but operation is suggested. Now let us see what are the methods of the treatment available for heart valve disease. We have today, one is an interventional procedure, that is non-surgical, through the balloon some of the stenosed or obstructed valves can be opened. For the regurgitation valves, we have to subject them to open heart surgery and then replace the diseased valve, or sometimes we can repair also. Or in mitral stenosis cases, sometimes we can open the valve. That also is a part of repair. So replacement of the mitral or aortic or tricuspid valves is very common. Tricuspid valve is not that very common, but replacement of the left side of the heart valve is very common, called mitral valve replacement or aortic valve replacement with the artificial valves developed. Artificial valves have been developed since 1960, and today we have got the best quality artificial heart valves. There are two types of artificial heart valves. One is totally made up of metal or pyrolytic carbon. It is called mechanical heart valve. Another valve is called bioprosthetic valve, which is made from the tissue taken from other animals. The advantages of the mechanical valves are that they are lifelong. But one disadvantage of mechanical valve is that the patient need to take regular dose of anticoagulation or blood thinning medication, which he has to properly do it, because if it is not done properly, there may be sometimes excessive bleeding in the other part of the body, especially in the brain and kidney. And if the dose is low, the mechanical valve can be choked or can get obstructed. The bioprosthetic valve is also good. The problem with the bioprosthetic valve, or the tissue valve otherwise known as, or the valves which are taken out from the other animals, they have got a tendency for undergo degeneration again, and they may lead to the development of stenosis of the valve, or short shrinkage of the valve, or sometimes they can go for regurgitation, or it can become again leak. This usually happens after 15 or 20 years. But nowadays, we have got a better quality bioprosthetic valves are there, so that the duration of their stay is more. So how to choose which type of valve we have to put for the patient is depends on several factors, and the sole depends on a proper discussion with the patient and the surgeon. In elderly patient, we generally suggest bioprosthetic valve, whereas in younger patients we suggest generally mechanical valve or metal valve, as their lifespan is more. So if you put a tissue valve, they are likely to go for a reoperation after 15 or 20 years. Anyhow, whichever valve is used, today we have got excellent valves of artificial valves at various prices, and these valves gives a good result. And whether to put a tissue valve or whether to put a totally mechanical valve, the decision depends on a proper discussion with the patient as well as the surgeon's decision. So what I want to convey today is that disease of the heart valves are very common. At the same time, one need not worry about that, because today we can diagnose the disease of the heart valves in early stage, and also we can decide the proper timing of the surgery or other procedure, and then we will relieve this obstruction or regurgitation by putting a high quality man-made mechanical or bioprosthetic valves, and if it is done at the right time, that will give the best life for the patient and the symptom better quality of life. The problem is that most of the time the valve diseases are neglected. Either the patient will not go for a regular checkup with the doctor, or they will say, okay, I don't have much of symptoms, let us continue with the medical treatment. So they will come to us when they develop severe symptoms. When they come with the severe symptoms, it usually will be very late, and so the best result we will not get, or the lifespan we will not get. So message, heart valve disease are common. At the same time, if proper operation at right time is done, that will give the best chance of living a good life and long life.